Hi, this is Pavel from Techytube.com, video number 2, and here I will show you the exact steps you need to pass to get Xcode installed and running on your machine. So, as I said, the main site is developer.apple.com. Just go there, and on the bottom left side you find a section developer tools. Press on it. And here you'll see a blue button to download Xcode. Just press on it. And it's got you to this section. And to simply memorize it, you just go upside here and see the link developer.apple.com/Xcode. And as you see here, the latest version is 4.4.1. And there is also Xcode 4.5, but it's a developer preview, which means it's a beta version, like a version in testing. And you see this button right here, press on it, and now it opens a model view where it shows you what you want to do to open in App Store. And if you don't know what App Store is, it's an application that comes with the iOS, with the operating system, macOS. I'll press OK. And it opens App Store on my Mac machine. And as you see here, I already pressed to install it, and it shows me that it's installing. If I go here in the Launch Center, I see the progress. I actually have an older version of Xcode, which is 4.3.2 for Lion, which I've downloaded before, and I got it ready to install. Here it is, and it's in DMG format. If you don't know what DMG stands for, it's a kind of like install format for Mac operating system. And we double tap on it, and it opens this window, and I just drag and drop it here in the applications folder. And now I have to wait to copy all the files here. As you can see now, it has about 3.5 gigabytes to copy in the application directory, and it's gonna take about 3 minutes on my machine, so we have to wait for that. As you can see, I almost got it installed on my machine. Okay, it's installed. And just to explain to be things more clearly, on the macOS installation is basically copying files in the application, in the applications folder. And after I got it installed, I just have to go and kind of eject Xcode. See, you just go in the drive where your macOS is installed, and you should see an icon similar to this, and press right click and eject Xcode. And now you have to go to where it's actually installed, and it's also on the main drive in developer folder. Actually, an applications folder. And first time it asks us that it's an application downloading from the internet, and if we are sure we want to open it, and we just press open. and we wait for it to open. Okay, it opened, and as you can see here on the right, it shows me all the previous projects I've already made. If you install it for the first time, you won't see nothing. It will just be blank here. And what we need to do to create our first project is to go over here on the left in the center and press create a new Xcode project. Here you have some templates to choose from, and the simplest one is, I guess, single view application. And we should give it a product name. Let's call this test one. And company identifier. It's usually like your company name, or your family name, and dot something like test one. This class prefix is optional, and we choose the device we want to run it, which is iPhone and iPad. Storyboards and automatic reference counting is something new in iOS 5, so I just uncheck this. I'll explain you later in another video what that means. Press next. Here you can check to create a local Git repository for this project, but I recommend not to create for now. Press create. Okay, here we have our first project, Xcode. You take a lot of time to familiarize yourself with Xcode. You can see here it's showing that it's downloading macOS 10.7 core library. And if you go up here in Xcode preferences, documentation, you can see actually the progress it's taking right now to install this library.